New Orleans, the city generally considered to be the birthplace of jazz. And although jazz did not suddenly appear there and nowhere else, certainly some of the greatest jazz performers were born in New Orleans, the greatest of which was Louis Armstrong. Hi, I'm Joe Bevilacqua. In the next hour, I'll be paying tribute to Louis Armstrong and New Orleans, the city where he was born. Throughout this program, you'll hear the sounds of New Orleans, recorded live during my visit to the French Quarter. We'll have exclusive interviews with trumpeter Wynton Marsalis and other New Orleans musicians, plus authors Donald Newlove and Bill Crow, and the members of the Preservation Hall Jazz Band. All that and more on Louis Armstrong's New Orleans.
I miss you when I care more than I miss you, Harley.
That blood pretty, actually. Blood pretty.
It's been said that the early recordings of Louis Armstrong are not a very good representation of how great he was and of the New Orleans style that he played prior to recording. This is something that trumpeter Wynton Marsalis disputes.
The New Orleans style of playing was more ensemble-oriented. Louis Armstrong was a great soloist, but the King Oliver Band recorded some a couple of great recordings with Louis Armstrong playing second cornet to King Oliver. But Louis Armstrong, in whatever he played, he had the spirit of that music in his sound. So there might be a few things that are different, and of course on a recording you never capture the real brilliance of the sound. And I'm sure when he was really stretching out and playing for a long time in those younger years, it was really quite exciting. But the essence of who he was as a man is captured. He's extensively recorded, and all of his recordings have that same personality, that same presence, and that same type of musical power and authority. And of even greater importance, he really represents the New Orleans tradition, everything about it. He's really the perfect representative of that sound.
Writer and jazz buff Donald Newlove.
I have the most beautiful records of him with Joe, where they keep inventing their riffs together, and Joe would do the fingering like this ahead of time, silently, and Louis would look over at the fingering, and then they would blow that riff together, and none of it was written. And people were sitting out in the dance hall, be amazed that these two guys could invent time together, phrases together, all night long.
Thank you. We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.